So it's been 20 years, I've been doing the exact same thing.
It has been already 20 years that I've been parking my car in the same parking lot, taking my bag and dance shoes from my trunk, walking the same walk towards my dance studio, opening the same door, sitting in the same chair waiting for my students to arrive. And they arrive. And then I teach the same basic moves for the past 20 years. The same basic steps and the same right turns. And now the big question. After 20 years, how do I keep my passion alive?
So before I go back to how I kept that passion alive, I want to go back to how Baila Production started. So I finished my BA and I flew to Taiwan to get a job. And I didn't know what I wanted to do at the end of my BA, and I flew to Taiwan and I thought maybe I'd become a ninja. So that sure didn't happen. And over there I started to teach English and I opened a dance school over there. And it was something I did on the side. So after a year and a half about, came back to Montreal and I thought to myself, well, why not try to open a dance school in the west part of Montreal? Which I grew up there. So there was no dance school, no salsa school. So I started a class with the support of my friends and parents. I had a class which was, I had my mother, my father, I had four of my friends and two clients. So that's the way Baila Production started. And from there, it grew slowly. I had absolutely no objective, no business plan. I didn't know what I was doing. I was just going by feeling. So I said, that's what I want to do. And it slowly grew at a steady pace. And then it became a thing after about 1 or 2 years. And slowly, more classes, more and more, you know, how like a normal growth of a business. But I didn't have any idea of opening schools, 1, 2, 3 schools, no projections. I was just happy to give classes. When I started my company, there was 3 things that I told myself before starting to teach. First, the moves that I'm going to be teaching should work with the majority of people. So I didn't want to create an elitist school where the moves were really complicated, almost like choreography based. So I wanted to think things to be really simple, so and accessible, and so that people can share them fast. So the curriculum was progressive, but at the same time, we would practice the same move during class for maybe an hour. So we didn't build like complicated moves where like there's 16 patterns to remember. And then when you go out dancing, it's already hard to remember patterns for guys. So we don't want to make it over complicated. Just the physics of motions and, you know, and then have fun, you know? So second thing I wanted to do brings me to the fun aspect. I thought that teaching dance shouldn't be the first thing on my agenda. The mission of the company should be to have fun. So the first thing is to use dance as a tool to have fun together. So that was very important for us. So everything was geared towards that. The third thing was customer service, customer service, customer service. And I won't say it enough. I think we're not so much in a dance business, but more into a customer service business. We're here to serve people. So what does it mean to serve people? Well, first of all, as simple as returning a phone call, as simple as being attentive to the needs of people, as simple as saying hi, smiling, giving time, making sure everything's all right, remaining open, making sure that people feel comfortable enough to come and see you, being accessible, making a lot of channels of communication so people can reach you easily. So all these little things that like a really good business do, like you know how you feel when you get good customer service? I want you to feel that way. I always thought customer service was the most important thing at our company. And those were the 3 things which I used to create the mission statement. And from then on, we went forward. Now, I've been doing this for 20 years, so the company already 20 years celebration of Byla Productions. And there's some moments where my passion was tested, and I wasn't sure about what I was doing. I wasn't motivated at all. And I remember one of my coaches said something that really struck me. That was the first time I thought about changing my mindset. I knew that my coach was teaching privates like all day. So 8-9 privates a day, six days a week. And I thought it was crazy. I thought I couldn't do that. And he said, yeah, he said to me, if you try and you build up the clientele, you end up comfortable, you're not gonna be tired, and it's feasible. But I said, don't you get, I don't know, like bored or discouraged or like you lose motivation? And he said, no, never. So I said, how do you do that? He said, every time I see my students come through the door, I remind myself that when my students come through the door, he lets me do what I love. The reason the students come through the door makes my passion possible. So this link between you guys, your students coming through the door, or you watching videos, makes me, makes my job possible. So when you start looking at that, because I love teaching, if people won't come through the door, can't teach, we have a problem. So this kind of link, so every time I would see clients come through the door, I would shut everything, if I had a bad day, whatever, I would shut everything in my head. I would just be really present for the client. I'll be there, I'm giving you a class, I give you my 100%. So that was the first kind of switch. Because at some point I was, yeah, not down, but sometimes you know, in any business you go through waves and you lose motivation, and then you need some kind of light or help or, you know, something to wake you up and go back to the right path. So that was one thing that I remember till this day. Another thing I remember, I was teaching a footwork class in a YMCA close to my studio. And I did it for 2-3 years. And I was literally teaching the same footwork class, because it was an open class, anybody could get in there. So every day was the same thing. I would go there on a Tuesday and teach the same class. And I remember there was a guy, a trainer, that used to come and watch the class. And he would watch me, and that's it. He wouldn't say anything. And he would just walk away when the class is finished. And at some point in time, we crossed paths, and he looked at me like after a year or two, and he said to me, I don't get it. I see you teach the same class with a lot of happiness, energy. You're there, you're having fun and stuff like that. And he said, it's always the same class. How do you do it? And then I thought about it. And for me, I never looked at the material or the technique I was delivering. I was just looking at the people having fun. So this is something also that clicked in my head. So as long as I see or look at the people, whatever I teach is irrelevant, meaning that even if I teach the same beginner class to the same people, same levels, always the same kind of class, I don't think about that I'm doing the same job. I'm just looking how people are reacting, how people are receiving it. Are they happy? Are they open? Are they closed? And I just concentrate on that. And that in itself is way more motivating than just thinking about you're repeating the same actions. Also, it's a question of focus. What are you focusing on? For example, let's say you're a hairdresser. So you can think about your job as just cutting hair, right? So let's say I'm doing my job and I'm thinking, oh, I'm just cutting hair, I'm tired of cutting hair. Or you can think of you're making people pretty and making feel good about themselves. So if you switch and you think about that, then the motivation comes from within, you know, you're happy to help people be better. So I think it's also what you're looking at, what you're thinking about. I always said that, let's say if you're unhappy with your work and you're like, you're complaining, you're like, oh, I don't like the job, blah, 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 blah. And I think you have only two options. You have or switch jobs, right? Try to find something that makes you feel better, or switch attitude, right? So because if you don't want to change jobs, sometimes there's reasons why you're keeping your jobs, security, money, whatever the reason you're using to justify keeping the job you don't like, then you have the other option of just saying, trying to find a way to like your job. So lastly, someone needs help at some point. I could think that I could do it alone, but most of the time I got unstuck with the help of other people, especially my coach. My coach is a very important part of my life, and also she helps me get unstuck whenever I get stuck in lack of motivation, I lose my focus, I don't know why I'm doing this anymore. She's been very helpful to put me back on track. So very important for you guys, if ever you get stuck, get some help. I did, it helped me a great deal. So finally, how do I keep this passion going? So you heard some reasons, some mind strategies, but basically is to go back to the original mission and to go back to the why. Whenever you're lost, let's say you're doing a job and you're lost in some kind of way, think about why you're doing this. I do this for the people. I do this to elevate people, to bring them joy. Everybody has a rough week, you know, they're working and they're coming just for 1 hour in our classes, or you guys are just watching a quick video. In my head, I always think about you guys. I think about what can I do to make it light, to make it more happy, you know, that the dance itself be a box that is full of fun and happiness so that you guys go out and then feel a bit lighter. That's the main goal of Byla Productions. Dance is just a tool for that. I could be doing pottery, same thing, same approach. You're coming to our pottery classes, we'll show you how you can do pottery while having fun. I think the brain works way better when it's in fun mode. Whenever it's closed up, frustrated, not happy, self-conscious, then I think it's not open to new ideas or just fun. So our goal at Byla Production is to make it fun for you guys, to make it light, and for you when you come in, you feel lighter when you come out. I want to thank everybody throughout the years that have been supporting us as a company. I want to thank everybody that's been watching our videos. I want to thank every staff member that came through our company and gave the 100% and their passion and love of salsa and love of our clients. Thanks for everything you did throughout the years. I pride myself in being surrounded with amazing people, and my only skill is to be able to choose these people. So I've been blessed to have a lot of good people around me throughout the years. And you know who you are, and thank you very, very much. I want to thank my family that have been supporting the idea from the get-go. As soon as they felt that I was zoned in, engaged, they never doubted the project. I want to thank my wife, of course, that never doubted me and was always supportive. And she was part of the company for a while until we got kids, which made it a little more complicated. But she was involved 100% in the creation of our second school, which was in Laval. I want to thank the current staff members that are working their butt off and they're giving their 100%. And to give you amazing classes. Definitely, I want to thank all the original OGs, the people that were there from the get-go, that have been with us for actually more than 15 years. I always am grateful when I see you guys, that you guys are still around. I feel that we grew up together in this company, and it makes me always joke about the fact that you guys are here for 15 years, and I always tell you guys, you know, one day you'll understand, you know, you'll get it, you know. And, you know, it's a joke, of course, but I think about you guys when I You know, every time I see you, it's like a brotherhood almost, like in a sisterhood, of course. Thank you for all the viewers also of our YouTube videos. Thank you for dropping a like, commenting, creating a vibrant community, and we read all your comments. I read all your comments. I'm the only one reading the comments. And thanks a lot for those nice 20 years. I've been blessed. I'm extremely happy and grateful to be part of this, basically. And hopefully another 20. And on this note, thank you all. Take care. Have a good day. See you in the next video.